You've probably heard the expression in Buddhism, emptiness is form, and form is emptiness. So today, let me share with you some ideas on emptiness. Look around you and be aware of the space you're in, the space in your room, the space outside your room, the space between your fingers, the space between objects. Well, this space that you're aware of is a window to a much deeper reality. Let's look at some of the ways both ancient philosophers have spoken about it, but also what science may say about it. So let me first talk about the concept of the Akashic field or the Akashic record. This holds a significant place in various esoteric and Eastern spiritual traditions. So let's look at this a little bit. First, the background and the terminology. Akasha. The Sanskrit word akasha means ether or sky or the infinite void or the deeper sphere of reality. So in many yogic and Hindu traditions, it is considered one of the five fundamental elements and the underlying substance of the universe. Then there's the concept of Akashic records. This term refers to a theoretical compendium of mystical knowledge encoded in a non-physical plane of existence. It's envisioned as a universal library or database containing all thoughts, emotions, actions, and experiences throughout the past and present and potential future timelines as well. Also, if you're familiar with theosophy, the Theosophical Society, which was founded in the 19th century by people like Helena Blavatsky and Ledbetter, described it as a cosmic archive accessible through higher states of consciousness. The Akashic records are believed to be like an enduring memory within the very fabric of reality. Every occurrence is thought to leave an imprint or vibrational residue that becomes embedded within this field. Theosophists suggest that trained individuals can access the Akashic records and through meditation practices like astral projection or heightened clairvoyance. This information provides insights into past lives, according to theosophy, karmic patterns, and the potential trajectory of the future. In Vedanta and Samkhya philosophies, the idea of a subtle cosmic memory is present in some schools of Hinduism. Some interpretations see it as akin to the causal plane from which thoughts and the manifest universe emerges. In Buddhism, the Akashic records are not mentioned as such, but Buddhist traditions speak of a vast interconnectedness and the idea that all beings and phenomena are intrinsically linked. Okay, so that's a little bit the Akashic field. And Akasha is understood in Eastern wisdom traditions. But does science support the idea? Does science support the idea that empty space contains energy, information, or memory? So it's very complex when you ask scientists, and they'll speak of quantum fluctuations. In the quantum field theory, even seemingly empty space isn't really empty. Due to the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, particle antiparticle collisions occur, and particles and antiparticle pairs constantly pop in and out of existence. These virtual particles carry energy known as vacuum energy or zero point energy. Then, of course, today there's a lot of conversation about what is called the cosmological constant and dark energy. cosmological observations suggest that around 70% of the universe's energy density is due to what's called dark energy. While not fully understood, dark energy could be a property of space itself. Does empty space contain information? Whether empty space encodes information like a memory store is a fascinating but open questions according to science. Some theories suggest that the entanglement of particles, a quantum phenomenon where their states become linked, might leave an imprint on space-time itself. And as I said, quantum field theories are exploring this. And according to quantum field theories, the classic idea of particles is now explained as just the behavior of the field. Think of the field like an ocean where ripples of waves represent particles. And the vacuum state, the emptiness of space in the vacuum, corresponds to the lowest energy state of these quantum fields called quantum vacuum states. Even in this state, the fields are never fully still due to quantum fluctuations. Also, space and quantum field theories is an active medium. It's the stage where particles are created and destroyed and fields interact with each other. So empty space isn't truly empty. It teems with quantum activity and contains energy. And now some are suggesting that it also contains information, and that my empty space may be a space of information storage. And quantum field theory gives us a dynamic picture of space where emptiness is filled with potential. So is empty space the source of everything? Space, time, energy, information, matter, gravity. And it seems to suggest that right now, according to science. So according to, of course, Einstein's theory of general relativity says that space and time aren't separate, but a single fabric called space-time, and that mass warps space-time, the presence of matter, including energy. So empty space is full of energy. It curves space-time. This curvature is what we call or experience as gravity. But now science is even suggesting that space-time might not be fundamental. Some theories suggest space-time itself to be an emergent phenomenon from something that is beyond space-time, totally non-local. So quantum entanglement suggests that as well. So now, is this space a domain of subjectivity, this space which contains the quantum vacuum, is this a domain of subjectivity, or is it a domain that's purely objective? Because if space-time, the very fabric of the universe, might be created and sustained by a vast network of entanglement, then entanglement could be the thread that stitches the geometry of space together. And this actually also brings up the topic of wormholes and EPR. There's a theory called ER equals EPR. This conjecture is the fascinating idea that links entanglement to wormholes. It proposes that entangled particles might be connected through microscopic wormholes, suggesting a hidden structure within space-time. And the nature of black holes suggests that entanglement could be crucial to resolving the black hole information paradox. It's theorized that information isn't truly lost in a black hole, but instead becomes entangled with the emitted Hawking radiation, as it's called, preserving it in a subtle way. Okay, so now if that is all true, or science is going in that direction, then let us ask the most important question, and that is, are observer and observed entangled? Are they one? Because if the space is objective, then the Akashic field becomes irrelevant. But if this space is also subjective, then the Akashic field becomes very relevant. So our observer and observed intertwined. Now, in Eastern traditions like Buddhism, Advaita Vedanta, the seeming separation between the self and the world is an illusion. The concept of non-duality posits a singular reality or consciousness lying at the heart of all existence. The observer is the observed is a famous expression, and it expresses this idea. Your mind and the object you're observing are both manifestations of the same underlying reality. And now, you know, when we look at science, quantum mechanics, there are really these mind-bending experiments like the double slit experiment, which show how subatomic particles like electrons can seemingly exist as waves of probability until observed, at which point they collapse into a definite particle. This points to a possible role of observation or measurement in determining the concrete nature of reality. Interpretations such as the Copenhagen interpretation of quantum mechanics highlight how the act of observation seems to be tied to the results. And of course, there's quantum entanglement, a bizarre quantum phenomenon where particles become linked in such a way that measuring one instantly affects the other, no matter how far they are. How far apart, even light years apart. This suggests a fundamental interconnectedness in the universe that defies our usual notions of separation between objects and what is being observed. So, if observer and observed are one, then the Akashic field is the quantum field also. And the space around us holds the secrets of the past, present, and future. And those secrets are the Akashic record. So I feel that slowly, through both an scientific understanding of space and the idea that there's a fundamental reality even beyond space, the Akashic field, which is the repository of every experience that has happened, every experience that is happening, and every experience that will happen, that is the ultimate consciousness which holds the secrets of everything in the universe, the secrets of mind, the secrets of our subtle body, intellect, ego, the secrets of our perceptual experiences, the secrets of our cognitive interpretations of those perceptual experiences, and the secrets of the entire universe, both subjective and objective. So the secrets of space-time, energy, information, matter, black holes, wormholes, multiple universes, and even the secrets of how we perceive those and how we construct the ideas of space-time, information, causality, and even the big elements and forces of the universe, such as particles and force fields and quantum fields, are all born in the womb of creation, which is the Akashic field, the Akashic record, the womb of creation. So develop a relationship with space without interpreting it. And know that your body is also made out of that. Your brain is also made out of that. Your mind is also made out of that. And that these boundaries that separate me from space and from other objects are just perceptual tricks called Maya in the play of the universe that we call Leela. I find this idea very exhilarating and liberating, and actually takes us way beyond the constructs of birth and death. So let me know your thoughts.